There were eyes in Palis, a district where the leaders there are worried about the high rates of teenage pregnancy and school dropout rates. Now, according to a new study, only 4 out of 10 pupils in Palis, a district, actually complete the education cycle. Let's have the details.
You are almost welcome.
This study carried out on 75 government-aided schools was conducted by the Citizen Initiative for Democracy and Development Uganda, a non-government organization. The survey was conducted between academic years 2018 and 2019 in Palliser District, which has a total of 76 government-aided schools. According to the findings, 13,317 children were enrolled into primary schools in 2012, but a total of 7,752 did not complete the primary school cycle by 2018, representing 58% dropouts and 42% completion. The objective of the survey was to determine the enrollment and magnitude of non-completion of the primary education cycle in the district. The report also indicates that the district is also losing a huge sum of money in terms of universal primary education capitation grants due to high school dropouts.
The outbreak of COVID-19. So this one did not only affect performance, it also made our children to become pregnant.
The report further indicates that most sub-counties with higher non-completion rates are Axim with 78%, Opatet at 72%, Kamuge 68%, Agule 66%, Kasoda 61%, while those with lower non-completion are Apompong 37%, Palliser 45%, and Palliser Town Council 47%.
Because of the big numbers, we have now a challenge of high teacher pupil ratio. The schools are really overcrowded. The classrooms are overcrowded. Teachers are very few.
Palliser District LC5 chairperson attributes the high rate of school dropouts to poverty, irresponsible parents, and deep-rooted negative cultural norms. He noted that traditional activities such as rice growing, where children are employed to scare away birds in the gardens, are also the major causes of school dropouts.
We want the answer. If it means walking in heaven, we shall walk. There are challenges which fall on the side of the district. They always tell me the money for inspection is not enough. They don't always do inspection. We want to make sure there is a seriousness. If the money is there, we want to make sure at least something is available to them.
He says rampant teenage pregnancies and negative attitude towards education in the communities have worsened the situation. As a result, woman MP for Palliser handed over scholastic materials to boost the children's ability to stay in schools once they reopen.
I want to ask the parents, let's get back and do our role. We may blame teachers, blame the DEO, but the biggest problem also comes from home.
The RDC has in the meantime warned men against luring young girls into sexual activities. Story by Paul Watala for the news.